Hey guys, Sinan from Car Inspected here, and someone was asking me earlier today about high interference versus low interference engines, and I just wanted to make this short video just to show you guys the difference. Now, inside of the engine there are pistons moving up and down, and there are valves opening, intake valves, exhaust valves, etc. Once the piston moves up in the cylinder to its top dead center or its topmost point before it starts coming down again, and the valves are fully open, if the engine is a high interference engine, then there is a high possibility that the valves are gonna hit the piston as it moves. Now, if it's a low interference engine, then the valves will not hit the piston. Why is that important? If a timing chain or a timing belt is to snap, that scenario is more than likely to happen, where the piston moves up and the valves are fully open. So if it's a high interference engine, then there is a good chance that you have bent valves, and that the internals of the engine are done. Basically, you need another head, or you need another set of valves to be installed. There would be damage to the inside of the engine. If it's a low interference engine and the timing belt or timing chain snaps or gets cut, because the timing chain is what controls the opening and the closing of the valves. If it is in a running order, if it's in a working condition, then the piston would never come into close proximity with the valves, because that's what the timing belt does. It controls the opening and the closing of the valves with the movement of the piston to make sure that nothing hits, and to ensure the continuation of the four-stroke cycle. But if there is a low interference engine, a timing belt or a timing chain snaps, then you have a good chance that the internals of the engine are in good shape. Now, the way to check this is, if you're ever in that condition — I hope that no one is, but these things do happen — get a borescope camera. You can get them from Amazon or eBay for relatively cheap nowadays, and just make sure you get the right diameter of the camera, just so that it'll enter. So basically what you're gonna do is remove the spark plugs and put the borescope camera into the spark plug hole, and check the surface of the piston, the top surface of the pistons, if they are scored or if they have scratches on them. I've done this on an older model Honda Civic. It was a 2000 that had the timing belt snap, and I found out that the internals of the engine was okay. Another car was a 2008 Mini Cooper S. It's a high interference engine, but somehow she was really lucky. The car was okay, and I put in a new timing chain and a guide and a tensioner, etc., and the car was working fine. Well, anyway, so the way to check is get a borescope, put it in the spark plug holes, all of them, and check if there are any scratches on the top of the piston. Of course, the standard way of checking is also to do a compression test of the cylinders. But if you do a compression test, you have to understand that the cycle is not, the pistons are not sealed, because sometimes the valves are partially open. If the timing chain or the timing belt is snapped, then the valves are gonna stay in their last known position, so that some cylinders are gonna have open valves. The valves are open, so it doesn't matter what you have to really know how to deal with the engine to do the compression testing in those cases. You would need a more advanced mechanical knowledge to be able to do the compression testing correctly. Because if you close the valves and the piston is on it's on its topmost position, then you're gonna get almost zero compression on that cylinder. Anyway, it's a relatively complicated subject, but the compression is not the only way to tell. Just get a borescope camera, they are relatively cheap, and go inside of each cylinder and check the top of the pistons, and of course check your coolant to see if there is any oil in it, and check the oil to see if there is any coolant, etc. And that'll give you a very good idea of the condition, the internal condition of your engine. So I hope that this helps someone out there. I hope that no one goes through this, actually. But yeah, so if you're ever stuck in this position, this is what I would recommend to do. I guess I'll see you on the next video.